during this time, I've seen like a lot of companies, I'm sure you guys have too, like Equinox, they created their own app, and on their separate app, they have like all this amazing fitness training that they were offering for free for a little bit, but it was free if you remember. And it was like literally some of the best training ever. But the issue I thought was, it's a complex problem because one, you're changing behavior, right? So you're moving somebody to an online setting, which COVID has helped significantly with, but there's still a barrier there. And then two, the class better be damn good. And that's the hard part, right? And then I'm like, we actually had an Equinox trainer on the podcast that she was filming a bunch of these things. And I was like, how often do you have to film? Like, how many times do you have to go through these takes? Because you're literally working out while you're coaching us, while there's four people in the room doing the same motions. And like, you're trying to tell me somebody didn't get tired? Like, somebody definitely got tired and walked away. And so it creates this, it's hard. It's hard to keep that energy high. In terms of how you guys view it, I just think about it like it's also an opportunity for young companies to almost show the behemoths how to do it, right? So if you guys, like it sounds like in your case, you're onto something, you know you're onto something. And so the funding opportunity, I would say, is now, because you have the right market signals. At the same time, it's a cool maybe opportunity to partner with a bigger player and say like, look, don't reinvent the wheel. We've already kind of figured this out.
Yeah, we have the methodology and like the fun and like community dialed in. We need a Diego. We need a tech person to partner with to just take care of all of the back end stuff that you have to continue to update. It's a never ending thing. Like, technology changes so quickly and you really do have to keep up, or if your load time is slow, people will go somewhere else, even if you are the coolest, most fun yoga teachers in the world.
Yeah, no, it's so true. But
I'll say something to that. I was going to say, what's interesting with the pandemic and what it brought for us, you know, Chrissy said our early iterations of Sky Ting TV videos that we launched with were like beautifully directed, had two cameras, you know, and like different shots, all edited, like really, really clean. We did voiceovers for the audio. So teachers weren't speaking live on camera. It was all like a really clean audio done in a sound studio, et cetera, et cetera. And those videos are great. And, you know, obviously they're still on our website. But what we got as far as feedback from students when the pandemic started, they were like, I kind of like these iPhone shot videos in your home better because you're like more yourselves. You're like laughing, you're making mistakes. And it feels like you're practicing with me as opposed to like being on this like pedestal of practice. And that, I think that's something that we've always done well at Sky Ting, is like really humanize the experience. And it's not about like us being your guru or your ultimate teacher. It's just like, we are like you, we're figuring our shit out just the way you're figuring your stuff out. And like, we're happy to go through this journey with you, which I think brought, like, especially during the pandemic and like the realities of the situation, like Chrissy said, we like, you know, live on levity and we live on bringing joy and trying to spark that within the yoga practice. And so that was an interesting learning lesson for us too. So now when we're in studios doing these classes, we are trying to keep it still a little more light, a little more real, because the perfectionism that I think has existed for a long time in pre-recorded video space, especially with fitness, it's just kind of like, okay, that's cool for a while, but then it's boring. And like, I don't want to take somebody who doesn't make a mistake and who's like, you know, at a perfect angle with every posture. I want to see somebody that like flubs or needs to modify, or like, yeah, I don't know, just is a human being.
That's me. I'll flub all day.
You can be our next model.
I'll
we'll
be
bring
like the
you
most the most approachable yoga teacher right here.
Exactly.
Yeah. How to get all the moves kind of right. Yeah, no, I'm in. I'll embarrass myself. I don't mind at all.
Chloe, what you were saying about people commenting on the change in, we like the iPhone videos because you're more yourself. I mean, that's kind of what we've been preaching on this show, is like, you don't have to be perfect. Like that, to me, what that shows is growth. Like we were talking about earlier, you're hitting your stride and you're growing into this platform and you're getting better at it. You don't have to be perfect right away. You can allow time to figure things out as you go. The important thing is just to start. Whatever you're doing, just begin and learn along the way. That's part of the process. And it's a scary part because it's a big unknown. But by allowing for growth, you can really, I mean, you guys could come out of this and go back to the super interesting multi-camera angles shot in beautiful high definition and bring along with you the experience of shooting it at home on your iPhone, relatable content that everyone's going to just digest with fervor and really just hit a new level. So like looking forward, how do you think you guys can capitalize on this? And do you have plans for going back into a actual studio sometime in the future and kind of rolling back with the multi-camera angle productions?
Yeah, I mean, that is what we're doing now. We're in studio with our fancy camera guy, Derek. Shout out, we love him. But we laugh because we're really one-take wonders. We were like, let's keep the mistakes, let's keep the cursing, and no more voiceover. So that is what we learned. And looking forward, I think we'll just like keep refining and listening to our customers. Like, we really are engaged with our people, and our lifetime value of our customer is very, very high compared to other subscription-based models. I think because you feel like we're talking directly to you, we're listening to what you say, your requests on Instagram, and they can like talk to the teachers directly. We're always like on camera, like, hey guys, DM me, what class do you want to do next month? So that's a thing. And also, we want to keep the sense of community and are doing these lo-fi Zoom classes weekly just to like see who's actually practicing with us, that are just more for fun and not anything else. They're for free for now.
I'll share my number one sticky thing on these classes has been when I feel like the instructor's in my head. Like if I'm doing something for the third time and she'll say something like, I know it hurts, or like, I know this is the hardest one. And I'm like, how the fuck did she know? And
we're all psychic.
It makes me connect. And so to your point around like voiceovers, like I think that's great. Don't do it. Don't be the Guy Raz of yoga. Don't get the orchestra. Just be you. Just do it live. And it connects, and it's so right. It feels so much better. Like I'm always like, yeah, she understands how hard it is. Like when she's losing her breath and I'm also sweating, it's like, yes, she can't sound perfect, because then it would just be demoralizing to me. Like, how is she doing this while teaching and sounds perfect? And I'm over here dying and I'm not talking to anybody. I'm just in my own room. It's weird.
It has to be fresh. I mean, we teach these classes as if we have a live audience. We're trying to recreate the live studio experience through digital, which was tricky, but I think you're right. We found our groove now. It took us, you know, a year of learning, but we're in a good place, I think.